Our next item is hunting from the roadside right-of-way.
Jerry.
Okay.
I don't think he will.
Mr. Chairman, this may be one that, this may be one that I think Mr. Woodruff worked with. I don't sit on the Animal Control Committee, and I may need some help with this one from some of the members of that committee.
I'll make a motion to table.
I don't think that you should table it.
I think it's time-sensitive.
Yeah, I think.
It's time-sensitive.
I think it's on the agenda tonight. Let's do it. I think we all understand it. I've got some questions about it myself that I'd like to ask the committee members.
The reason that I made that motion, I mean, because we told people at the public hearing that they would be notified of our actions.
Well, this is a notification. I mean, this is a public meeting.
It's a public meeting. It's been on the agenda. They've had the public hearing.
Bourbon County now.
I mean, they got their notice at the public hearing.
Getting a notice.
Didn't you just say y'all trying to shut me up?
No.
Just say that.
Yeah, we are.
Well, I just put a motion up. They let it die for a second. Thank you.
All right, there's no second.
Oh, it died. Now I'm happy.
Okay. All right, and I think our purpose tonight is to vote it either up or down one way or another. But I want to say this before anybody makes a motion is because I think it's going to pass, and I could be wrong, but I would just kind of like for us to make sure that the hunters don't get cited or arrested for when it's time to pick up their dogs. That's my only.
I've got another issue. I'm in agreement on that, and I've got one other issue.
Okay.
The issue I have is that this could be. I read the resolution, and the resolution is very brief. And I think if we don't rewrite that resolution to be more specific, when we send it to our legislators, something may get lost in translation. I think maybe we should let our attorneys look at it, and maybe they could write a better resolution and one that our legislators may be able to take and do more with. You had the issue with the dogs. I agree with that 100%. These dogs are valuable to them, and they should be able to have those dogs. Also, there is something that says about the right-of-way. I don't have a problem with hunters hunting from the right-of-way, providing it's on the private property side of the right-of-way. So they're not on the right-of-way. They're beyond it by a matter of inches. To do that, they're going to have permission from the property owner.
You're saying to be on the other side of the ditch?
Exactly. Private exactly. Property. They're going to have to get there by road or whatever. And that could be provided. They could put it in themselves. But that way, you're not saying you can't hunt from generally the position you've always hunted from. You've just got to make sure that you don't hunt from the area where people are driving and the area where the public owns, at least has owned right-of-way to.
There is a legal description of right-of-way.
Yeah.
I mean, and you're either in the right-of-way or you're out of the right-of-way. And nothing in here limits you from hunting outside of the right-of-way. It says you can't take game from inside the right-of-way, and that's what it'll come down to if a case went to court. Now, let me give you some help on the exact wording, where it says, be it resolved that it is unlawful for a person to hunt, take, or kill any wild animal or game bird with a firearm or bow and arrow in the person's possession from, on, or across the right-of-way of a public road in Beaufort County. We specifically said to officials who are going to enforce this, what wording do you want that's easiest for you to enforce that causes the least confusion insofar as people hunting with dogs, hunting in the right-of-way, picking up dogs, walking across the right-of-way with their gun, and all of these other issues that's easiest for you to enforce? This is the language that they gave us that said this is the easiest for us to enforce, and that's why this is the language that's presented.
All right. So, I mean, Mr. Russell.
Yes, sir.
Captain Russell Davenport, here. If this kind of a language, of course, your group's going to be called into question to enforce this. One of the groups. There'll also be the wildlife people as well. With this language, will you understand that on the other side of the right-of-way, even inches, that they're safe and secure, and they're fine, they're not aiming across the road. I mean, if you see them aiming across the road, you got them. But, you know, they're not there to aim across the road or down the road. They're going to be hunting from that position and shooting across the field and into the woods.
I think the question he was asking was, can he taking the game is the word. And he's asking about walking across the road with a rifle. Well, no, you're not going to get arrested walking across the road.
But if you walk across without the rifle, you'll be okay.
No, with the rifle, you're okay. As long as you're not taking the game. That's why the taking of the game is in there.
Okay.
If you're standing in the road with your rifle and you're shooting, you're in the right of way and you're taking game.
Yes, okay.
That's why the wording of the taking game is in there.
That's
so,
right.
So you've got this set up so that if you see him with his rifle inside the right of way, he's cool. If you see him raise the rifle, then he's out of bounds and you're going to take him in.
If he raises rifle and he takes game, which he's going to fire the rifle,
yeah,
he'd be arrested.
You see him standing in the right of way and he's listening for the dogs and you hear the dogs coming, you know, he probably won't get arrested, but he'd probably get a warning, hey, look. You know, it looks like you may be getting close to violating
the law. He really doesn't need to be holding that gun.
Yeah. I mean, you know,
that would be the way to do it.
There's ways to stay out of trouble.
Yeah.
This doesn't say a thing about dogs, so I presume it's okay to get the
dogs. You can get dogs. It doesn't limit dogs.
This is a public meeting. It's taped, and nobody wants to keep anybody from their dogs.
No.
Let me ask this question, Mr. Chairman. Did you say something about, you said something about having permission of the landowner if you're off the right of way? Mm-hmm. Would that permission be in writing?
Whatever the landowner wants to do.
That's a separate issue.
Then would the hunter have to have the permission?
He better.
Permission in
writing. He's in trouble. There's other laws to take care of that.
No, give me a chance to talk. I'm talking about for Mr. Davenport here. He goes up to the hunter. The hunter says, I have permission to hunt on this land. And Mr. Davenport could say, well, let me see the written permission for you to hunt on this land. And he has to produce it.
But Mr. Davenport wouldn't be there unless he got a call from the landowner.
Let me address that.
He could get a call from somebody driving down the road saying, right, this guy.
But he probably wouldn't respond to it.
To the committee.
Why wouldn't he?
The committee.
Because he's not inside the right of way.
Okay, hold on, Commissioner.
The committee addressed this. We talked to the wildlife people. And I'm not expert enough to give you a firm answer today, but basically what I remember is that if you're hunting on somebody else's land and you're challenged, you better have it in writing, otherwise you're going to be charged. That's, right. That's state law. Okay. So you don't have to worry about
okay.
that. The committee went into these things in detail. That's right.
If it's state law already, I got no problem.
That's right. It's state law.
I wanted to see it. I would think that would be important.
Yeah, and the law requires you to have it on your person.
Mr. Chairman.
Go ahead.
I've been a hunter all my life. I've hunted on the shoulder of the road. I feel deeply about this. I've talked to several hunting groups, and they're taking all the precautions that they can to make sure that it's done safely and take the danger factor out of someone being shot. I know that's not a good argument, but that's one that they will argue with. I do know that most of these hunt clubs do have liability insurance. The ones that I've talked with have liability insurance. They think it's very important that they have that in case something does happen. The comments that the young lady made there, I think, were right on. I know that some hunt clubs are trying to police their areas better than what they have in the past, and I think they ought to police the people that belong to the hunt club. It don't take but one person to screw the whole pooch, so to speak. And so for these reasons, I just can't vote for it.
Mr. Chairman, I own some land, and I leased 3 separate hunt clubs. So I'm going to have to deal with these hunt clubs after this vote. Now, having said that, in life, there's always going to be changes. I mean, in business, in your personal life, there's changes. And this is not a big change. It's a minor change. It's a change that hopefully will ensure that Beaufort County will be more in compliance with the other counties within the state, and there will be a sense of safety for the neighbors and a sense of better sportsmanship. So I think I'm going to have to vote for it, while I probably wouldn't have voted for it 10 years ago. Things have changed in Beaufort County. In fact, when I say I'm going to have to deal with the three hunt clubs, they'll probably appreciate me taking this vote. They're all still hunters now. So it's just, things are changing. We're going to ask people to hunt and seek permission. We're going to ask people to keep their dogs up, but they're going to keep them up anyway because they're valuable. And quite frankly, I don't see this as a restrictive ordinance that we're going to be passing. I really don't. So I'm going to have to vote for it.
Anything further?
Mr. Chairman, I too am going to have to support the ban on the roadside hunting. After the public hearing, I received a bunch of calls that in regards to personal safety of people in their own personal property. One guy said, well, I heard a shotgun. I looked over, and there's somebody shot a hole in my house while they're hunting a deer. Another person told me, well, we were working out in the fields in our garden, and we heard guns. We all of a sudden dove down to the ground, so they feared for their safety. Hyde County, bless them, put in a hunting ban, but they put in their hunting ban, roadside hunting ban, after somebody got killed. And that's a more sparsely populated area than this, and God help us if someone would get killed in Beaufort County, but with the way the density of the population and the houses have changed in Beaufort County, I believe we have a safety issue. We're the only county left that has no restrictions concerning roadside hunting. And I think a whole lot of the people are sort of congregated towards Beaufort County, and I believe it's time that we do something, and I support this.
Okay. Anything further? Hearing none, all in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, 6-1.
This will need to be transmitted to our representatives, yeah, very promptly.
Yes, sir.
Okay, manager's report.